After 3 years of work, this woman converted a vintage bus into a chic tiny home. Jessie Lipskin was feeling stuck in the ebb and flow of pricey and cramped city life in Manhattan and wanted to design a lifestyle for herself that would allow her far more freedom, financially, holistically, and sustainably. That's when she poked around on eBay and ended up making the purchase of a lifetime. Jessie had a wild idea, taking an old derelict bus and making it into her very own state-of-the-art mobile home. With her converted bus, she could finally feel free. But as it turns out, finding the right vehicle was going to be the least of her problems. The place where Jessie would make her new home was inside a 1966 Greyhound. Oddly enough, it was the same bus model that Keanu Reeves and Sandra Bullock have to save in the film Speed. Within the bus was contained 400 square feet of possibility. In order to map out the space they were about to create inside the bus, Jessie and her friends first had to totally gut it. To start the renovation project, they stripped out all the seats that it had come with and sold them to a restaurant. Now they had an empty hull to rebuild to their heart's content. They gave the outside of the bus a fresh new coat of metallic white paint to cover its grime. But in order to further the course of their endeavor, Jessie needed more help. Removing old furniture and painting was the easy part. Building an actual home would mean bringing in experts. Setting up the various rooms inside the converted bus was far more than just deciding what would be where and starting the building process. A key challenge in constructing the home inside the bus was the calculations needed to make it work. Whatever was built had to remain sturdy while the bus was in motion. The proper angles for each structure had to be figured out with the utmost precision. That way, doors would open or close as they ought to, even if the parking angle was slightly off kilter. This added extra time to the woodworking and the project overall. But bit by bit, Jessie's fantasy home began to take shape. The bathroom inside the converted bus would have to be sustainable, in line with the philosophy that had guided Jessie's decision-making from the get-go. Thanks to the high ceilings of the bus, they were able to construct a fully functioning standing shower. Beside it was a slotted floor made of mahogany wood for the bather to stand on to dry off. As it would happen, the space that the interior of the converted bus afforded would allow for far more than one might think at first glance. Not only were Jessie and her friends able to install a closet for her to hang her clothes, the bus would ultimately have three closets in total. Outside the bathroom, the flooring of the converted bus was covered with a layer of polished hardwood. Then they gave it a real sense of flair by installing an LED lighting system. The lights were set with dimmers so the person sleeping in the vehicle could create their own ambiance. Now the basics were finished and it was time for the heavy lifting. No decision was made without research. Importantly, all the household appliances for Jessie's tiny home were carefully chosen so as to fall in line with her initial vision of being energy efficient and earth conscious. Her friends helped her to log in and install the appliances, and one feature in particular was especially delightful. Having a bus lined with windows had a great advantage when it came to creating a space for Jessie's kitchen. She could now cook while enjoying the scenery around her, right in front of her face. As she learned the ins and outs of construction, Jessie herself took part in building the kitchen's wooden countertops. She found inspiration from other people who were constructing tiny homes in a similar fashion and posting their results to Instagram. Stage by stage, as she and the experts enacted their interior design magic, she documented their own work process too, and she had a great idea for the bedroom. Perhaps the most important space of all was a comfortable corner where Jessie could rest her head. Once she'd completed the bedroom, complete with cozy velvet curtains, she set up a table at the back of the room. Then she piled her book collection onto it so that it could serve as the bus's own miniature library. After 3 years of work, the converted bus was finally complete. It is truly a marvel to behold. The chic mobile home was a fully functional, furnished, and equipped home that some apartment owners would doubtlessly be jealous of. The decked-out bus boasted two separate air conditioning units, three different walk-in closets, and its entire electricity and water system was environmentally sustainable. The tiny home was visually stunning, but it needed a touch of color to spruce it up. Still, Jessie had to stay thrifty and be resourceful. At a Goodwill, she snagged an oil painting with gentle tones and hung it up in the central hallway of the converted bus. Any space could be lived in, but after 3 years of work, she had to make her space feel personalized. It's the little details of design that Jesse thought made her converted bus feel that much more like a home. And one item in particular, of absolutely priceless value, made its way on board. Jesse's great-grandmother had lived in the poor immigrant tenement buildings on Manhattan's Lower East Side. She'd managed to buy a set of fine china dishes, no doubt a sign of prestige given her surroundings. Passed down through the generations, they now graced the table in Jesse's tiny home. But it wasn't just this heirloom that set her converted bus apart from others. Jesse had a special advantage when she set out on her DIY project. Although she lacked the technical experience for building, she had her own skill set that she was able to apply to the project, her natural propensity of being organized. She was able to maximize utility of the space allotted within the confines of the converted bus. After having carried out the project of a lifetime, Jesse had plenty of time to reap its benefits and enjoy the great outdoors. But despite the years of effort she'd placed into making her dream a reality, Jesse Lipskin eventually decided that she had to sell her converted bus. The bus was put up for sale on Craigslist, listed at $149,000 with 100,000 miles on it. For Jesse, the dream had run its course. She felt that even this tiny home was simply too much for her. But thanks to the cozy and luxurious space she'd created, the converted bus was about to enter a new chapter in its life. The tiny home has returned to where its journey began, running full circle. It's being rented out as an Airbnb for desert travelers and guests who are raving about it. Thanks to Jesse's ingenuity, the space can sleep up to 4 people, making for the perfect desert getaway. But despite its obvious charm, not everyone is a fan. Although the concept of creating a mobile home had initially appealed to Jesse Lipskin because it would afford the possibility of not feeling weighed down by city life, she's opting to take that lifestyle a step further. She's currently employed in a job that allows her to work remotely, and she intends to take full advantage of that opportunity. At 30, she's looking to go abroad for a little while and work as she travels. Because she has the ability to work remotely, she doesn't want to feel tied down by the responsibility of tending to the bus and wants the freedom to travel and explore. It's the same principle that guided her while building her tiny home, utilizing her freedom to the max.